back to the Penn Sports Network. I'm Mike Mahoney, and I'm here with Darren Ambrose. And Darren, you guys had another good weekend. You had Brown here. You were able to escape with an overtime victory. A little dicey there down the stretch, but a 3-2 win. Just talk a little bit about an exciting night Saturday over at Rose Field.
Yeah, it's one of those, you're fortunate to be a part of, I think. When you're going into the game, we had to win. We always talk about just taking care of our results. And if we wanted to have a chance to play for a title, we had to win. So the kids knew what they were playing for. And Brown haven't given up many goals, so we knew we would have to be opportunistic. And first 20 minutes or so, we things almost came. It was like an almost kind of game. It was almost coming off. And when we scored our first goal, I thought, maybe now we'll settle down and we'll take over. But credit to Brown, they made it very difficult. They came back at us, and we still had chance after chance. I thought we were dangerous down the stretch. And going into overtime, we just told our kid, do the same things that you've been doing, and you're going to get a goal. And they did. And it was, I'll be the first to admit, I was the first one on the field when we scored, and I was excited for our kids. I think they deserve to be where they are right now.
It was an interesting day of Ivy League soccer. You had the top four teams playing the bottom four teams. Columbia and Harvard both losing their games. Yeah. You and Princeton both winning in overtime.
Yeah.
That leaves you guys at the top of the table. It leaves Princeton in second place. You guys are the only two teams left standing for the title. Just talk a little bit about kind of how this weekend was a microcosm of how the whole season's been in Ivy League play.
Sure. No, it's a great point. As I said before on the show, that any weekend, first place can lose to the last place team. The league, there's a lot of parity in our league. We have similar rosters. All of us have good players. And on the day, if they play well, you've got a great chance to win. If you don't play well and the other team does, you're probably going to lose. So I think it's a credit to the league that we are so close. And it's made for an exciting year. It's made for, every Sunday you look in the morning and see where you are, because you don't know going into it. Right. And that was the case this weekend for us. I was at home and I heard the Columbia result, and suddenly the things changed. And our kids knew about it and they were excited. So,
we talked about this earlier in the week, but obviously Saturday's game up at Princeton now, a 4 p.m. start.
Yeah.
Big game, a win or a tie, and you guys get the Ivy League title and the NCAA bid. A Princeton win and the Tigers get the bid and the title.
Sure.
Just talk a little bit about your expectations heading up there on Saturday and what you expect with the atmosphere and the game itself.
Sure. I wish it was tomorrow. I think our kids do too. I mean, it's like a cup final. I mean, it's like we don't have a tournament, but it's like a tournament final. It's a championship game in every sense. I think the atmosphere will be fantastic. It's a great place to play. It's a good stadium, great field. We all know what we're playing for. We're not going up there to play for a tie. I mean, I don't think you can go and defend for 90 minutes against a team like Princeton. We're going to go and try and win the game. As the game wears on, then we'll adjust and react to whatever we need to. But our mentality going in is, we've won a lot of games, and we're not going to change a lot of things. We need to keep doing what we do. And then as the game goes on, if we need to adjust, we will. But our mentality is we're going up there to win.
All right. Well, it was a good week, and when you're at the top of the table, honors tend to come with it. You guys swept the weekly awards in the Ivy League. Marin, McDermott getting the Player of the Week. Kerry Scalora, her third Ivy League Rookie of the Week honor.
Yeah.
Just talk a little bit about their play last week and how they've been helping out.
Yeah, they've both, every game, they've been a factor in our games. Whether they've scored or not, they've always had an impact in some way. And Marin has been kind of knocking on the door quietly. She's been grafting away. Some things haven't come off for her, and there's been stretches in some games earlier this year where I think she was just off a little bit. But to her credit, she's been going at it and going at it. And if you're watching her play, it was just a matter of time. And her time came on Saturday. She's continued to put herself in those spots. If you put yourself in those spots often enough, good things happen. And she's continued to do it. And I'm happy for her. I think she was fantastic and deserved the award. I mean, and Kerry has been great all year. As we know, she's capable of changing a game with one pass or one shot. She's got a great left foot, and again, a nice goal from 30 yards or so against Lehigh, and fantastic service into Marin for the goal. But she does so many other things too. She's such a threat all the time that I think teams respect her, and that they're always trying to pay attention to what she's doing. And as a younger player, that's often hard to deal with. But again, she's found a way to contribute in every game. And again, it's a good sign for us, and I'm really happy for her.
So there you have it. Marin McDermott, the Ivy League Player of the Week. Kerry Scalora, the Ivy League Rookie of the Week. Penn at the top of the table. playing a championship match this weekend, Saturday, 4 p.m. up at Princeton. For the Penn Sports Network, this is Darren Ambrose, and I'm Mike Mahoney.